الحمد الذي خلق السماوات والأرض وجعل الظلمات والنور ثم الذين كفروا بربهم يعدلون. الحمد الذي أنزل على عبد الكتاب ولم يجعل له عوجا. نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على حبيبنا وشفيئنا وقدوتنا محمد ابن عبد الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه. فيا عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله. يقول الله تعالى في كتاب الكريم بعد أن نستعيذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. وقال أيضا: واتقوا الله واعلموا أن الله مع المتقين، ومن يتق الله يجعل له من أمره يسرا، ومن يتق الله يكفر عن سيئاته ويؤذم له أجرا. Dear brothers and sisters, I did receive many emails and they asked me to talk about how to raise our children in this country. And before I answer that question, when you read the Quran, there is many dua of the prophets. And many of these dua, they are focused that those prophets, those messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant him a children. For example, Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, he always said, Rabbi habli min as-salihin. Oh Allah, grant me righteous children. And Prophet Zakaria, the way he made dua is difficult even to translate into the English. When he said, Rabbi inni wahana al-'azmu minni washta'ala ar-ra'su shayba ولم أكن بدعائك ربي شقيا وإني خفت الموالي من ورائي وكانت امرأتي عاقرا فهب لي من لدنك وليا. والله he said, my bone is weak, I am old, and then my head shining with gray hair, and my wife barren. But I never give up to ask you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So please, grant me baby. The question is, why is it? They know they're old already. They know their wife is barren, but always begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number one, because having children is nature. Having children is something that Allah put in the heart of the people, whether Muslim, non-Muslim. He said, زُيِّنَ هُبُّ الشَّهَوَاتِ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ وَالْبَنِينَ. Beautifies is love of the joys come from women and children. Nature. People sometimes adopted children because they want to have children. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said also, Al-malu wal-banuna zinatul hayati dunya. The wealth and the children, that's what make life beautiful for us. Beautiful. Life is changed. Right? That's the first reason. Children is a blessing. The second reason for them, especially prophets, is they're worried about this deen, about this mission, about this risalah. Who will continue the message? Like Ibrahim alayhi salam, inni ja'iluka lin-nasi imama. Ibrahim, I give you a certificate now. You become imam, role model. What Ibrahim said? Qala wa min dhurriyyati. Immediately, how about my children, my grandchildren? Right? So if children is blessing, every blessing Allah gives to us come with responsibility. So yes, you're happy with the children, but be careful. This is amana, a trust from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right? The Quran said, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara. Oh, you believe, save yourself. The Prophet said to Fatima, Fatima, even I am a prophet, I cannot help you. Save yourself and your family from hellfire. Said, Kullukum ra'in, all of you are sheep. So let me come to the answer. It says, so now how to raise our children emotionally healthy, spiritually upright, and morally good character. There are three components in raising children, and I call three A's. attention, affection, and appreciation. Attention, affection, and appreciation. This is very, very important. If you have to want your children grow up healthy, spiritually strong, you need these three things. The first is attention, al-intibah, al-ihtimam. This is the most problem that facing the children in this country, especially. When I say attention, that means especially give our children full time, not part time. That's what they need. Remember, I told a story last time. A father came home, tired, and his boy wanted to talk to him and said, "Go bed. Go to your bed. Daddy, come on, listen to me." The sister, please, if you have children and talking, please to the, bring to the room. Please. So, sister, so now the father, the son said, "Dad, how much they pay you for overtime?" He said, "Why you ask me? Please tell me." He said, $20. "Give me $10. I said, "What for?" "Just give me $10. "Okay, I give you and then you go bed, okay?" "Okay." So the father gave him $10 and he went to the bed and he have another $10 under his pillow and took back to his dad. "Dad, this is $20. Give me 1 hour." And the father cried. Right? And when there is shooting in the school and many children died, Paul Harvey, radio commentator, said, he said, "We treat our children like our dog and we treat our dog like our children." That's the reason. And you know, the prophet did say exactly, he predicted. He said, "Yati ala nasi zamanun li an yurabbi ahadhum jarwan ahabbu ilayhi min an yurabbi tiflahu." Will come a time that people prefer to raise chihuahua, to raise puppy, right, than they raise their own children. Sheikh Yasir Fazaga, he was invited into Unitarian Church, and after finish lecture, because he's therapist, the pastor said, there's a family want to talk to you. And family came. As soon as they saw him, they are crying. He said, "We just lost our children." And then they describe about the cuteness of the children. And he said, "Because of these children, you know, we make sure there's always somebody at home. So they make sure that when the husband go to work, the wife is home. When the wife go to work, and the husband home. So in order that the children can easy access to him, he make a stair into his bed." And then on and on he described about when they went to the park and beautiful. And they cry. And then they saw the picture of the children. It's not children, it's chihuahua. Small dog. They pay attention just to make sure there's somebody at home. They have time for it, for the pets. Another story, a young man graduated MBA and he went fishing to the lake. He saw a fisherman. I said, "What are you doing?" "I'm fishing." I said, "Fishing 4 hours a day. And then I went home, I have lunch with my family, and then I went to the cafe, I have chatting with my friend, and then I went home again and I have spent all time with my family." I said, "Oh man, this is the wrong way. What I have to do?" "Man, you have to work at least 12, 14 hours. Then you can sell the lobster and make benefit, and then you hire people. And then you can sell to East Coast, to California, to different. And then you can go to public." "What do you mean go to public?" you have a stock. And then he said, how long will it take that? He said, if you do right, 14 years. And then what? And then you can come back to me here, and then you can just fishing 4 hours, and then you have lunch with your family, and then you go to cafe, and then spend rest with your family. So she said, you want me to do all that job in order to do the same what I'm doing today? Subhanallah. And on that time, all my family is gone already. My son already married, maybe. Subhanallah. You know something, we do the same. He said, when people, they are in 30, man, I have to work hard so I can relax when I'm 40. And when I reach 40, man, I have to work harder so I can take rest when I'm 50. And then 50, oh man, it's not enough. You know, I need to work hard so I can relax when I get retirement. And during 60, khalas, finish. So the brothers, this is very, very important. Time and time, time. Our children need all the time. You know, sometimes a father or mother said, you know, I do anything for my children. I'll give my eyes, my heart. So keep your eyes and your heart. They know all the time. And also when you save time which you didn't, you have to be careful. Time for them, time for them. So when your children talk to you, turn off the laptop, the iPhone. Halas. You know something, you get mad, you talk to your children because they play a game. Listen to me. Dad, wait. And then you do the same. The children watch that. If somebody, your children, want, you are scoring somebody, and they don't want to talk to you, many parents said, shut up, I'm talking. I said, no, talk to your friend. I said, wait. I call you back. My children need me. The children will feel something. I'm more important than his friend. Subhanallah. Because there are two types of togetherness. Togetherness only physical. Like if you're watching TV family, everybody watching different channel. And togetherness emotionally and spiritually. And some parents only they pay attention if their children made mistake. So they were the children, you know that. She always made mistake. That's the only way I can attract my children. Question to you now. Who is the busiest one in the world? Very busy. Who? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is a prophet. He is a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the leader of the community. He is the general in the army. But he always have time for their wife, for his wife and the children. He always play with them. You know, when you visit Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what Rasulullah doing? At home, on the street, they play with the children. So therefore, when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he came from everywhere, the children rushing toward him. Al-Amin, Al-Amin. Because Rasulullah used to, you know, give them like candy, you know. And then he didn't have candy, he used to wipe their head. I'm sorry, we don't have nothing today. And their mothers, they knew because they smelled something from their head, from the pie wiping of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He knows the story, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has something, he pray, he make long sujood because of the children was playing with him. Always. Right? One time Rasulullah he saw, he said, Anas bin Malik, he said, Wallahi, I live with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam for 9 years to be his servant. He never said to me, why you doing this, why you don't do this? And one day he asked me to buy something, and I was late. I play. And Rasulullah come from behind. And close, he put his hand on my eyes. He said, Anas, did you buy what? He's not yelling, he said, oh, you, subhanallah. Yeah. But at the same time, when he said attention, Rasulullah attention to everything, including his behavior. It's very important, especially we live in this country. He said, one of the Sahaba, his name Umar bin Abi Salama, he said, I never forget what did he teach me. I was eating, I didn't know the etiquette of eating. I put my hand everywhere. Rasulullah was just watching like this. You know, many of the parents said, don't do it. Don't. Rasulullah never said, do it. Don't unless necessary. He looked at him and said, قُلْ يَا غُلَامُ فَإِذَا أَكَلْتَ فَسَمِّي. If you eat, say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Right? And then he said, قُلْ بِيَمِينِكَ. Eat with the right hand. وَقُلْ فِيمَا يَلِكَ. And eat what in front of it. Very polite, very gentle. Right? And this is very, very important. Especially if you have children you bring to the masjid. Educate them at home. You know, I always talk with the convert to, you know, American become Muslim. You know, how people in the church, the children was disciplined, polite. And they told me, said, before they bring them to the masjid, they educate them. Hey, you're going to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're going to meet a lot of people. You know, you have to be polite. So the children understand that. And then when they come to the church, they make sure where their children is. And we have custom in our country, when number one, when they bring people, the kid to masjid, it's not like he get one to relax. Khalas, I'm going to rid of you and do whatever you want. And then when the guest came, a very non-Muslim came, when you see the kid run away in the masjid, this is not good pictures. So that's the first one, attention. The second one is affection. He said, children want to know that they are loved. In Islam, what in your heart had to be expressed, especially concerning love and caring. Rasulullah was sitting with his companion, and men passed by. Rasulullah, I love him. Did you tell him? I said, no. Go tell him. So we have to express our love, either by word or by expression, by action. Remember, I told a story about Rasulullah used to kiss his grandchildren, Hassan and Hussein. And a Badawi came. He was shocked. He saw Rasulullah kissing his grandchildren. He said, Wallahi, Ya Rasulullah, I have 10 children. He was proud, boasted. I never kissed them. Because on that time, to be manhood, to be a man, that means you have to be firm. Even with your wife and children, that's a man. And if you not do that, you are weak. Subhanallah. And Rasulullah get angry. He said, don't blame me if Allah take the mercy from your heart. Subhanallah. Yeah. So therefore Rasulullah always call people with their nickname. Right? How you call it Aisha? Ya Humaira, Ya Aish. American, they are good. They call baby, sweetheart, honey, pumpkin. That's the way the Rasulullah used to call it, you know, his wife. You call it Aisha, Khadija, never. Right? Even his friend, he called Abu Bakr, Ya Siddiq, Ya Farooq, Saifullah, all his nickname to express the love. Yeah. And even one day, Rasulullah he saw Jubair. Jubair was playing an old woman there. Teenager, 16 years old. And he said, Jubair, what are you doing here? And Jubair was, his face was red. He said, what I have to say now? Oh, Rasulullah, you know, Jamali Sharud, my camel always ran away from me. So I asked all his women to make a rope. Okay, that's all right. And then one day he met Jubair again. Jubair, he said, how is your camel doing? He said, Wallahi, I didn't have camel. It was, Rasulullah, no, I'm lying. Oh, it's okay, no. It's good, no. And then one day, I saw Rasulullah was behind me. I walked faster. And Rasulullah ran. He said, Jubair, how is camel doing? I said, it's okay. And then one day, I was behind Rasulullah. I walked very slowly. And Rasulullah was waiting for me. And he said, Jubair, how's your camel doing? And then one day, I'm in the masjid, and I saw Rasulullah coming, I make long spray. Rasulullah sit there. And he said to me, Jubair, I wait for you. And then I hug Rasulullah. This is Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He wants to address the issue, but the way Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, through affection. And the last one is appreciation, takdir. Yeah. Mean acknowledging what people doing, acknowledging what your kid, your wife doing. So be careful. When your kid did something good, even small ayat, mashallah, praise them. You know, in some country, there's no praising. Praising is considered weak. So you make people, his head is big. There's one sister complained, said, why are your children so mean? You know, because in our country, they don't praise anybody. The Prophet said, man la yashkuru nas la yashkuru Allah. Who does not thank people, that means he does not thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah. I have a very good story, but it is true. But it looks like funny, but I want to share with you. You know, there is a friend, he brought his friend to his home, and his wife, mashallah, he did cook very good food. And after finish, in that custom, the husband and wife waiting in the door to escort all the guests. And everybody just thanked to the husband, mashallah, beautiful food. Nobody says a wife in one word to appreciate his wife. His wife just wait. And even the last one he said to her husband, may Allah give you hura'in. May Allah give you beautiful wife in Jannah. So that's okay. But at least her husband, after finished the dinner and the left, the husband got, at least the husband said something. Honey, mashallah, thank you very much. All my friends very happy and helping, you know, to clean the dish. And no, the husband just go sleep. The next month, the husband called his wife. Honey, you know my friend who came last time, he enjoyed your food, they want to come again. Can you cook? You know what the wife said? Holy hur mita hurin mita tatbuh. Let your hurin in, cook for you. Say something. So this is the very, very important three elements: attention, affection, and appreciation. And listen to the hadith said, kama tadinu tudan. As you do, you should be done to you. That means how you treat your children will treat you when you are big. If you have these three, inshallah, they will do the same with these three to you when you are need them. In Basra, there is a man was tie his father's neck like a slave, like this, and pull it. And then when the father want to stop, and the boy was get mad, quick, dad. And somebody want to intervene, want to hit the boy, said, no, leave him alone. Because this is what I did to my father before. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْكُمْ وَلَكُمْ وَدُمُوا بِاللَّهِ. Alhamdulillah hamdan ya fi ni'amika fi mazida ya rabbana lakal hamdu kama yanbaghi li jalali wajhika wa 'azimi sultanik inna allaha wa malaikatahu yusalluna 'alan nabi ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu 'alaihi wa sallimu taslima allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik alayh. So there's three components how to raise our children, but at the same time there's not enough only at home, so we need the support of the community. So therefore it's very important for the parent to enroll in the especially masjid community. Alhamdulillah, summer is over. This is time to be serious for us and for our children. So inshallah, I encourage everybody inshallah to look to the MAPS website, the Quranic study with Sheikh Nabil will start. It's very, very important that we have our children. Yes, maybe they are engineer, they are doctor, but they memorize Quran, they answer Quran. Right? Also, I have a class called Islamic study every Tuesday and Wednesday, right, from 9 years old until this is because one of the problems our children, the lack of knowledge of Islam. But also it's not enough for your children. I need to encourage us, everybody inshallah, to be involved, to increase your knowledge. I have Sharia fiqh class every Tuesday, and I have called Tafsir al-Mawdu, thematic tafsir, that every Thursday. So So at least pick one of them. Be involved. And also we have halaqat every Friday and Sunday. So please come. And this is very important for the next generation. And the last one, inshallah, so make sure that you always ask questions. What I can do for this community? And also, after finish the salat, inshallah, we're going to have salatul janazah for Dr. Iqbal Malik. He is the brother of Mumtaz Malik. Yeah. And also the last one, inshallah, don't forget to take the flyer. The Samamish Masjid is going to have a fundraising. Allahumma ja'alna minal ladhina yasmuna qala fa yattabi'una ahsana. Allahumma hinna ala al-islam wa sunnah wa tawaffana ala al-imani wa tawbah. Allahumma barik lana fi awladina wa wafikhum ila ta'atik warzukna birrahum. Allahumma ya mu'allima Musa wa Adam allimhum wa ya mufahima Sulaiman fahimhum. Rabbana hab lana min azwajina wa dhurriyyatina qurrata ayun waj'alna lil muttaqina imama. Rabbana atina fid dunya hasanah wa fil akhirati hasanah wa qina adhaban nar. Wa sallallahu alaihi wasallam alhamdulillah rabbil alamin.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Hayya 'ala s-salat, hayya 'ala s-salat.